Hey everyone, I'm Kyle, and in this video, I want to help you improve your Appian forms. Forms are a big part of any Appian application. They're how your users input the data that your application's built around. But a poorly designed form can leave users confused, slow them down, or lead to increased errors. Take a look at this form from InsuraCorp, used in a portal to provide potential customers with a quick estimate for auto insurance. The form collects information about the applicant and their vehicle and performs a calculation to return an estimate. It's fully functional and meets the basic requirements, but it could use some work. In our sample form, the fields are kind of all over the place. We start with a few related to the vehicle, then state, but the rest of the address is way down at the bottom. Forms can wind up mixed up like this for a number of reasons. Maybe the fields were added in whatever order the developer thought of them, or in whatever order they're listed in the data model. Regardless of the reason, simply rearranging the forms into logical groups can make a big difference. With a simple update, the form is looking better already. When arranging fields, keep in mind common order conventions. For instance, in the US, where InsuraCorp's users are likely to be, addresses typically start with the street address, then city, state, and zip or postal code. Having fields in two or more columns forces users to think in two dimensions, horizontally and vertically. This can lead to confusion as users don't know which field to move to next, causing validation errors and skipped fields. Use a single column layout to avoid these problems. Here, I've arranged the fields into a single vertical column, which allows users to move in a straight line down the form and address all the fields in order. You can still use side-by-side layouts for related fields like first name, last name, and address components. When using a single column layout, it's also important to consider the width. Incredibly wide fields can be hard to track. You can narrow them either by using empty columns on either side or by using the form width parameter of the form layout. Here, I've set the form width to medium. This keeps the fields centered and ensures a consistent user experience across different screen sizes. When users see a long list of fields with no breaks, this can feel daunting. Also, since the fields are only differentiable by their labels, they lack context. For instance, a field labeled year might not be immediately recognized as referring to the year of manufacture of a vehicle. We can use sections with clear headers to break the content into meaningful chunks and also provide some context to the user while filling out the form. You could do this a number of ways, using cards, sections, or even just increased white space between certain fields. In this form, I've used the section layouts to break the content into three sections: one for user information, one for vehicle information, and one for coverage options. Forms are for collecting information, not for marketing or flashy designs. Using too much color can distract users from where we want them to focus. You should limit the use of color to direct user attention and to convey information. Here, I've changed the section headers from accent to standard, since they don't need to be the focus. I've saved the brighter colors for the buttons at the bottom. You don't need to abandon color completely, though. A subtle background color consistent with your company's branding can be applied to both form layouts and header content layouts. Here, I've added a light background color to the form layout. I've also added the fields to card layouts, making them pop against the background and section headers, further focusing the user attention where it needs to be. Selection fields like checkboxes, radio buttons, and dropdowns allow users to select one or more options from a list of possibilities. Choosing the right field type for the right field can enhance the user experience. For instance, a dropdown for ownership status works, but with only three options, a radio button field is better since users can see all options without expanding the dropdown. Dropdowns are more appropriate for long lists like state, make, and model. If you have Appian create a form for you, it may automatically use record pickers in fields that specify related records. And record pickers are great in the right circumstances, but they're not always the best option since users may not know what they're searching for. For example, InsuraCorp's users might not know their insurance coverage options. So here, I've used a card choice field instead of a record picker. Like radio buttons or checklists, this shows the available options, but also allows you to provide additional context, like a brief description for the coverage option to help users make informed choices. For other drop-down fields, like make and model, I've added some placeholder text as well. It's a good idea to add placeholder text to drop-downs and picker fields to easily distinguish them from regular text input fields. Our form looks great, but it's still a little bit long. Having a large number of fields on screen at one time can increase cognitive load and leave users feeling overwhelmed. It's best practice to limit the number of visible fields on screen to about 5 to 7 using progressive disclosure. One method is using a wizard. A wizard is a great option when there are multiple sequential steps that need to be completed, and when users would benefit from a more guided experience. Here, I've used the milestone component to keep track of what step of the wizard the user's on, with each step set up in the steps parameter. In expression mode, I set up a local variable to keep track of what step the user's on, and to set this local variable as the active parameter on the milestone component. I've also configured the buttons at the bottom of the form to increase or decrease the value of this local variable when clicked. The showWhen parameter on each section is used to show a given section only when the local variable has the corresponding value. For forms that are very long or where the input data is very important, having a review step can help users feel more confident that they've input their data correctly, and allow them to correct any mistakes that they might have made. After the user completes the initial three sections, I've set up a final section of the form to allow them to view their estimate and review the information they've entered. And with that, our form is done. Our fields were arranged and broken up meaningfully, the form is legible and easy to follow, and the wizard reduces the stress of a long form. Using these tips can help you take your forms from functional to beautiful and intuitive. But remember, there's no single best form layout. Always keep in mind who your users are and what they're trying to do. And you can always find more design guidance in the Appian documentation. Just search for Sail Design System. And be sure to subscribe to this channel for more Appian development tips. With that, thanks so much and happy building.